believe yourself and you can make the mountains move. So this is something that I read in the morning itself and I wanted to share it with you guys. So believe yourself, believe your dreams, believe your goals, and you will definitely succeed. I am Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs at Anujindal.in, and today I have brought you some most important current affairs for phase 1 of banking examinations like RBI, SEBI and NABARD. So without wasting any time, I will be moving ahead with this video and we will be discussing our first question. But before that, I would like you to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell notification and also join the Telegram group in order to get guidance, or you can connect with your mentors also on that Telegram channel. So now from here onwards, we will be discussing the most important questions for the day. So do listen to me very carefully till the end, and in case you have any kind of doubt, you can mention it in the comment section below. So here is the first question. Which state has launched Ardhvika? Ardhvika means Every Girl is Unique program for development of adolescent girls aged 10 to 19. So which state is it? Is it Madhya Pradesh, Odisha, Andhra Pradesh, Rajasthan, Gujarat? Out of these options, the right answer is Odisha. Odisha has launched this Ardhvika program on the International Day of Girl Child. So when is this International Day of Girl Child observed? Do you guys know? It is observed on October 11th. And in 2020, the theme of this day was My Voice, Our Equal Future. So this is the theme and this is the date of International Day of Girl Child. You have to remember these things. These are very important from the examination point of view. So now let's discuss about this Ardhvika program. What is the purpose of this program? As the question is also mentioning this thing that Ardhvika is for the development of adolescent girls who are aged between 10 to 19. And this scheme will be, this program will be implemented by Anganwadi centers. And how are they going to implement it? Under the scheme, Kishori cards will be distributed to the girls, to adolescent girls. And those Kishori cards will have information about the health, nutrition and safety training of the girls. So in this manner, this Kishori card will contain all the information related to adolescent girls, and these Kishori cards will help the government in formulating new policies regarding the protection, the development and empowerment of adolescent girls in the state. So this is all that we need to keep in mind for this question, for this news, because we have covered the news comprehensively from phase one point of view. And now my question for you is that you have to tell me the CM of Odisha. This is very important for us to know that who is the chief minister of this state. Do mention your answers in the comment section. And here comes our second question. So second question is, which state has launched the Impact mobile application to monitor the action taken under the Preconception and Prenatal Diagnostic Techniques Act 1994? So before discussing the answer of this question, I would like to discuss this act first. So the act, the name itself is suggesting preconception and prenatal diagnostic techniques test. So prenatal refers to before delivery. So before delivery of the baby, in order to curb the sex determination test and female feticide, this act was launched. So what is the two? What are the two purposes of this act? First is to curb sex determination, and second is to abolish female feticide. So these are the two things that this act aimed to do. Now, in order to monitor the actions taken under this act, state has launched this impact scheme. So which state is this? Impact mobile application. So which state is this? It is Rajasthan. Rajasthan has launched this impact mobile application, and this application has been developed by National Informatics Center. So NIC is the nodal agency for developing the apps and portals of the government at the center and at the state level. So that is why NIC has developed this app. Do remember these facts about this question. Again, my question from you is the CM of Rajasthan, because these are the minute details that a current affairs student should know about the questions and about the news. So do not forget to tell me your answers in the comment section. And here comes our third question. So the third question is, which country's think tank, which is TAEF, which is short formed as TAEF, has partnered with India's National Maritime Foundation in order to foster cooperation in the Indo-Pacific region? Quite easy to understand the purpose of this collaboration, so we need not to discuss it at length, because it is very obviously written here that it is to promote cooperation between India and the company and the country from which TAEF belongs to. So which country does this think tank belong to? The answer is Taiwan. And how can you remember it better? Through the full form of TAEF. So the full form is Taiwan Asia Exchange Forum. Now I hope that you can easily remember the answer of this question, that Taiwan has partnered with India National Maritime Foundation to strengthen the cooperation in Indo-Pacific region. So that is all that we need to cover from this question, from this news item, and we will be quickly moving on to the next question. So the next question is, which company has partnered with AICTE to provide training to learners and education and educators in new age technologies, including AI, Internet of Things, and data science and cloud computing? So these are the new age technologies in which AICTE aims to provide training to the learners and educators, the teachers as well as students. So with which company has the AICTE partnered with? The answer is Microsoft. Now guys, do you know what is the full form of AICTE? The full form is All India Council of Technical Education. Now you would be thinking that I have told you the full form, then what could be my question for you guys? So your homework is to tell me the chief of this AICTE organization. And do you guys know that AICTE is the regulator of technical institutions, technical higher education institutions like IITs? So IITs and other information technology institutions are regulated by AICTE. So I hope that you can remember it better, and you will answer your you will give your answers in the comment section below. And here comes our next question. So the next question is very easy for us, because the question is clearly about a line of credit. So here there are only keywords that you need to remember in order to remember this news. So what are those keywords? The keywords are, first of all, let me read out the question, then I will tell you the keywords. So the question is, which country has received a line of credit of $310 for the purpose of financing repowering of one thermal power station? So for the financing of this thermal power station, Exim Bank has given a line of credit of $310 million to a country where this thermal power station is located. So which country is it? Can you guess? The country is Zimbabwe. So to Zimbabwe, this LOC has been given. Now guys, your task is to find out the capital and the currency of Zimbabwe, because it is very important, and in the examination, questions like these have been asked previously. So do tell me your answer. And that's all that you need to cover from this question. So the keywords that you need to keep in mind are Zimbabwe, Exim Bank, loan amount that is LOC amount 310 million, the country that is Zimbabwe, and the power station for which this line of credit is being granted, because this is very important. The other way around that this question can be asked is that where is this thermal power station located? In which country is this located? So this is very important for you to remember the country in which this thermal power station is located. I hope that I am clear till now. And this question is, what is India's GDP growth rate for FY21? That is 2020 to 21, according to International Monetary Fund's World Economic Outlook Report. First of all, let me tell you that this World Economic Outlook Report is a biannual report. It is released two times in a year. And now, in the second edition or in the biannual report, International Monetary Fund has downgraded India's GDP forecast. So what is the new forecast? The new forecast is -10.3%. Apart from this, IMF has also said that India is going to grow at a growth rate of 8.8% in FY22. So FY22 is 2021 to 2022. So India's growth rate would be 8.8%. And for FY21, it is -10.3%. Now guys, I have a picture for you, from where you can easily remember the GDP forecast given by other organizations. So let's move on to that picture. So in this picture, you can easily see the different organizations and their earlier as well as now, their current GDP forecast. Now guys, do remember this thing. I repeatedly say that you are not required to learn to memorize the previous GDP forecast. Do not remember them. Just remember the latest forecast, and that too, just remember those forecasts before examination, the latest one. So let's have a look at the GDP forecast given by different organizations, because it will give us the idea about economic situation of India. So S&P has given -9%, ICRA -9.5%, World Bank -9.6%, IMF -10.3%, DBS -10.5%, Fitch -10.5%, SBI -10.9%, Nomura, which is in Japan, so this is an investment agency. So Nomura has given -11%. Moody's has given -11.5%. India Ratings -11.8%. So these are the latest GDP forecasts. You have to keep them in mind. And now it is our next question, which is, who is the chairman of Association of Mutual Funds in India? So quite important, because Association of Mutual Funds in India is the apex body that regulates mutual funds. But SEBI is the regulator, is the official regulator of mutual funds, and this AMFI is a non-profit organization. So it works towards the promotion of mutual funds in India. Now the chairman has been re-elected. So the chairman which was earlier there, he has been re-elected. So who is that person? It is Nilesh Shah, option A. Nothing to discuss much about this, because it is a very easy question of an appointment. And next question is about a new award that has been constituted, a new award that has been established. So the question is, which of the following personalities have partnered to launch the Earthshot Prize? First of all, let's discuss the answer of this question, and then we will discuss something about this Earthshot Prize. So what is the answer? Which two personalities have partnered? So first is Prince William, then David Attenborough, and then William Alexander. Option D is both A and B, and both B and C. So the answer to this question is option D. That is Prince William of Britain and David Attenborough, who is a very renowned environmentalist, they both have partnered to launch this Earthshot Prize. Now guys, this Earthshot Prize, the name itself is suggesting the purpose. It is in the field of environment. So those who are doing excellent work in the field of environment to address the challenges which are there in the field of environment will get the prize, will get the Earthshot Prize. Now, what is the amount, what is the value of this prize? So it is the very prestigious prize till now in the field of environment because of its prize money. So what is the prize money? It is €50 million. Do remember the prize money as well, because this is the largest ever prize money that is being given to any awardee under the International Award for Environment. So that's all that we need to cover about this question, and now we will be moving on to our next question. So the next question is, with which organization has Swimming Federation of India partnered to develop world-class swimming coaching facilities? Quite easy to understand the purpose of this collaboration. So what is the answer? The answer is option C, Moorboard Sports. Now this is a sporting agency, this is a swimming sport agency in Australia. Do remember this thing, that this is an Australian agency, and with this Swimming Federation of India has partnered to develop the coaching facility, to develop the swimming coaching facilities in India. And that is all that we need to cover from the exam point of view regarding this news. I have a question for you now. You have to tell me that who is the chief of this Swimming Federation of India, because again, these are the minute and background informations that you need to collect and memorize for your examination point of view. Then comes our next question, which is about a book. So this is an autobiography titled as De Bachava Karni. So whose autobiography is titled as this? Those who are from Maharashtra or who know Marathi can easily guess the answer of this question, because it is a Marathi name. It is a Marathi title that has been given to the autobiography. So now guys, can you tell me that whose biography is this? It is option A, Balasaheb Vikhe Patil's biography. And he has been a Lok Sabha member for multiple terms and a BJP leader, and that is why this autobiography has been recently released by Pradhan Mantri or Prime Minister Narendra Modi himself, and therefore the importance of this book is very much. You have to remember the autobiography of Balasaheb Vikhe Patil, the name of the autobiography, and he has been a Lok Sabha MP and BJP leader. So this is the very background information. If you want to remember it, memorize it. If you don't, then do not memorize it, because nobody is going to ask you about this thing in the examination. And here our session ends, and I hope that you have liked this session, and if you have really liked it, then do subscribe to our channel and hit the bell notification to get the latest updates. Thank you.